You know, most investors, if they're not working in our business, if they're not at BMO thinking 100% of the time about how to allocate prudently and appropriately to whether it's a new asset class like crypto or to AI, and where within AI do they buy Nvidia? That seems to be the most popular way to invest. But as we've seen from Nvidia with its earnings report, I mean, they reported spectacular growth rates that no one else is reporting. But now people are saying, wait a minute, given what's happened with OpenAI and all of the debates raging, maybe those growth rates are going to slow down a lot more than people think. So that is why we feel safer. And I think the advisors feel safer having a much more diversified exposure to AI, including not only AI and other hardware stocks like AMD, but also software stocks or companies that actually have data that no one else has, like Teladoc in the telemedicine space. So I think most advisors are looking for a diversified way to harness this, what we believe will be a massive opportunity in AI, but there are diversified ways to play it.
Welcome back to Unscripted Crypto, where we dive deep into the dynamic world of cryptocurrencies and emerging technologies. Before we jump in, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more insightful content. In today's episode, we've just heard Cathie Wood discussing the complexities of investing in AI and crypto. She highlighted the importance of prudent allocation in these rapidly evolving sectors, especially in AI, where companies like Nvidia are making headlines with their growth rates. But as Cathie mentioned, there's a twist. The rapid developments in AI, fueled by initiatives like OpenAI, might change the growth trajectory for these companies. So, what does this mean for investors? Let's delve deeper. While Nvidia is a popular choice, Cathie suggests a diversified approach to AI investments, encompassing not just hardware companies like AMD, but also software firms and unique data holders. This strategy mirrors the broader trend in the crypto and tech markets, where diversification is increasingly seen as a key to managing risks and capitalizing on opportunities. Up next, we'll explore how Cathie Wood addresses risk management in the face of unpredictable markets. Stay tuned.
Cathie, how do you manage risk? Because I think there's an important lesson here, right? As much as you do your homework and research, as much as anybody does, you can't get everything right. So how do you manage risk?
When many people ask me that question, they are making the assumption, I know you're not, but they are making the assumption that ARK is a generalist portfolio manager. Generalist meaning can touch any part of the market, can move into defensives, can move into energy, can move into staples. And so all we are focused on is truly disruptive innovation. So we should be a slice of a portfolio. With that said, how do we manage risk? When the markets start, when we enter a bear market because of interest rates going up or what have you, we will start concentrating our portfolio towards our highest conviction names for a couple of reasons. First of all, we have a scoring system, a six-metric scoring system that speaks loudly. But second, what happens is we're typically creating a tax loss and buying another stock that is also down. So we're creating a tax asset over time against which we can take future gains. And what's also happened because of the scoring system, we've noticed that when we concentrate, and we went in our flagship strategy ARKK from 57, 58 names in 21, that's in the US, to 27 names at the low, and now we're back over 30. What we find is we tend not to go back to, let's say, 50% of the names that we've sold simply because we don't have as high a conviction. And those tend to be good sales. at least 50% of them tend to be very good sales. So that's one measure of risk control. And then when we get into a bull market, the opposite of what I just described, we know that our portfolios are volatile. So what we will do when the market thinks that we can do no wrong, that is a signal that we need to diversify into cash-like innovation names like Apple or Meta Platforms. Now, we're not doing that. We have bought some Meta Platforms, but that's for truly fundamental reasons. The pivot away from the metaverse towards AI was very important there. But for the most part, we'll be looking for cash-rich innovation names because we will want to use those and sell them as we move into another, say, correction or bear market, because we know that the names into which we concentrate are going to have much more upside than the names we're selling.
As we just heard from Cathie Wood, managing risk in the volatile world of disruptive innovation is a top priority for ARK Invest. They focus solely on transformative technologies, making them a unique slice of any investment portfolio. But how does ARK navigate the choppy waters of bear and bull markets? Cathie's answer lies in their strategic approach to portfolio concentration and a unique scoring system. When markets turn bearish, ARK concentrates on their highest conviction names, creating tax assets through strategic sales. This disciplined approach not only helps manage risks, but also positions them to capitalize on potential market rebounds. Interestingly, during bull markets, ARK diversifies into cash-like innovation names, such as Apple or Meta Platforms, which they can liquidate in downturns to invest in higher upside opportunities. This brings us to an essential point for our viewers at Unscripted Crypto. How do we apply these insights to our crypto investments? In the crypto world, similar principles can be applied. During market downturns, it might be wise to concentrate on high conviction crypto assets and consider diversifying into more stable investments during bullish phases.
If you look at, you know, ARK Innovation earlier this year, a lot of investors bailed, but they're all coming back now. I want to get your thoughts on just how it made you feel. The ups and downs. Did it ever make you doubt your strategy?
Actually not. We go through, of course, we redouble our efforts on making sure the assumptions we're making in our research are correct. So it's a very healthy exercise. How do I feel? We have the courage of conviction in our research. So I feel, wow, we're getting great opportunities, and we usually concentrate our portfolios towards our higher conviction names. What I feel really, what does unsettle me is what you just said earlier. Investors leaving us at the bottom, missing a big move, and then getting in. Now, we went down so much in 21 and 22 that we simply, even after this year's nice move to the upside, we simply look like we're in a basing range. And whenever there's a long base, and I think we're in a long base period here, typically what happens in the market, that's a setup. It's a bulls and bears debating each other. What's going to happen either is a breakout of a trading range or a breakdown from a trading range. We, of course, now consider the source, but we, of course, think there's a breakout brewing because our technologies are ready for prime time. But again, as you ask me how I feel, it's more about how I feel for our clients, and I do. And that's why we're out there all the time, willing to go out when the markets are getting crushed and our stocks are under great pressure. That's even more important a time for us to get out and describe the depth of our research and the depth of our conviction as well.
For investors who are looking to dip into the innovation space, what's your advice to them? What should they be paying attention to?
Well, I think maybe the reason they want to move into the innovation space is they see the ground shifting underneath them in their own personal lives, and they know they're not exposed to it in the traditional broad-based benchmarks. You have to consider the source, but I do think diversifying into other innovation strategies that have names not in the big benchmarks, and most of ours fit, most of our strategies fit into that category, will be very important because, again, diversification of anything is a good thing, but especially in the innovation world, when we believe there's going to be a lot of super exponential growth opportunities, but they will come at the expense of disrupting or disintermediating some of the names in the broad-based benchmarks. So we're certainly a good diversifier at ARK. And I think most people, most investors are short truly disruptive innovation. And so this is a way to solve that problem.
Despite the ups and downs, Cathie's unwavering belief in her strategy and research has been a cornerstone of ARK's approach. This conviction leads to strategic portfolio concentration, especially during market lows, enabling them to seize opportunities that others might miss. What's crucial here is the emotional aspect of investing. Cathie expresses concern for investors who exit at market lows and miss out on significant rebounds. This scenario is all too common in the crypto world as well. Emotional reactions to market fluctuations can lead to missed opportunities and should be tempered with a well-researched, long-term strategy. For those looking to enter the innovation and crypto space, Cathie's advice is clear. Diversify into strategies that are not part of traditional benchmarks. This is particularly relevant for crypto investors. The market is ripe with disruptive opportunities that often don't align with traditional investment patterns, offering a unique diversification advantage. To wrap up, let's ponder this. How do you balance risk and opportunity in your crypto investments? Share your thoughts and strategies in the comments below. And remember, for the latest insights and discussions on crypto and technology, Unscripted Crypto is your go-to channel. Until next time, keep innovating and stay unscripted.